Good afternoon, children. Hello. Am I visible and audible? First question always. Namaste and good afternoon. Hello, Hriday. Yes, Sanjay, we have started. Hi, Sudhakar. Late. What is late? Who is late? By the way, your real name is also Aryan, okay? Nice to know that, Aryan, because I've been calling you Aryan all the time. Thank you. Okay, thank you very much for joining me. Vanakkam, Vijay Tarishan. Vijay Tarishan, I remember this name from one of the homework questions that you had given. Right? I think so. How are you all, children? So nice to be here with yet another KBC special preparation quiz. And how many of you have been playing the quiz, children, by the way? Let me ask you that. I'm good. Thank you. Thank you so much. Delayed by 6 minutes. What is delayed by 6 minutes? Session is supposed to start at 2 p.m., right? You are on time and we are also on time. Good afternoon, Kushagra. Good afternoon. Yes, everyone else. V-Quiz. My question is about V-Quiz, right? I'm right. Yes, Vijay Tarishan. I know that. The code is right here, 4059446. Okay, so today is going to be an exclusive mentee session. As all of you know, we've been having multiple KBC special preparation quizzes with many of your different master teachers, and today is my second KBC quiz. Okay guys, so get ready for this. Of course, Tanishq, how is week quiz going, guys? I know, like, you know what, many times these days, whenever I have sessions at 7 p.m., children would be missing from the class. And when I ask them what happens, like, in the next class, they'd be like, ma'am, we had gone to play week quiz. So I will be like, okay. So how many of you have also been regularly playing week quiz? Yes. How many chapters are, okay, me, I can see. Yes, good job. Nice to know that. Gautam Sai, hello Gautam Sai. I'm good, Kushagra, thank you. So let us get started, children. So I hope you are completely ready. You will win today, Naman. As always, Naman is here with full spirits. Let's see, okay. All right, so children, go to www.menti.com and use the code 4059446. So let me become smaller now so that you can see the questions properly. Yes, have I become smaller now? And I will put it in full screen so that you can completely see it. Yes, children, menti.com and use the code 4059446. Okay, let's see how many people we have today. Wow. How many do we have? Because this is, okay, I saw that comment, Devansh, I actually saw that comment, okay, before you deleted it. Now, Naman, in my regular sessions also, Naman is very quick in answering questions. ICSE Freak, you have joined. Nice to know that. Agnes, Rohit, Hansel, Devansh, Abhishek, yesterday you got 48th rank. Nice. Yes. I have become smaller, like Hanumanji, I can become larger and smaller when it's time for Menti. Okay, you got 11. Wow, nice. You will try to improve it today. All right. Oh, I think we are in a good position to start now. There are already 200 plus children right now. And I hope to have, you did not know about KBC quiz. Okay. So for those of you who are not aware of this, in the meantime, the rest of you can join. Go to www.menti.com. Use the code 4059446. Okay, 4059446. Okay, yeah. Note the code and join it. So for those of you who are not aware, KBC 2020 is around the corner and Vedantu is the official learning partner of this season of Kaun Banega Karorpati. And this time, they have a student special week. And of course, Vedantu being the official learning partner, we have to do something special for our children also, right? So this is why we have come up with giving you a golden opportunity to get closer to the KBC hot seat. So for those of you who will be playing WeQuiz regularly until the 18th of October, 11 a.m. and 7 p.m. every day, okay? Until the 18th of October, your chances of getting closer to the KBC hot seat is increased. All right. So shall we get started? Ma'am, I don't know Hindi, but what shall I do? For KBC, doesn't matter at all. I remember in my childhood, I used to watch KBC a lot. And I remember there were participants from southern parts of India also. All that is not a problem at all. Okay, so but definitely give it a try. Everything else is secondary. Okay. Hello, Sairam. Okay, children, 245 of you now. And I am very, very excited to begin. Let us move on. The code is right here on your screen, children, 4059446. So here we go. I will give you exactly 20 seconds for each question. Thank you so much, Vidya Tarishan, for saying that. It means a lot to me. Okay, yeah, let's move on. And here comes your question number one. Yes. Frederick Sanger is a twice recipient of the Nobel Prize for dash chemistry in 1958 and 1980, physics in 1956 and 1972, chemistry in 1954 and peace in 1962, physics in 1903, chemistry in 1911. By the time I finished reading all the options, we are almost done with our time and your time is up. No idea, doesn't matter. The answer is, as 82 of you, which is a majority of you, have said, it is option A, which is chemistry in 1958 and chemistry itself in 1980. Also, Frederick Sanger. Okay, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, because all of these non-Indian names many times can be a little tricky, but then as long as we understand who the person is, I think that's all that matters. Many of you have also said it's physics, but the answer is chemistry both the times. Okay, children, so let us look at the leaderboard and see who has scored how many points and who is at the first position, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on till position 10. Let's see. Okay, Yash is here. Thank you so much, Yash. Yash is the fastest. Naman, where have you vanished? Naman wanted to be first. Yeah. Punjabi hits ICSE biology live sessions as much as possible. We try to do live sessions, but the thing is that it's not always possible to do a live session because we have to plan accordingly for different teachers. So mentee sessions always happen live. Okay. So one second, children. Right. Okay. So let's move on. Okay. Not a problem at all. Nandini, Naman will lose. What does that mean? Okay, let's move on. Naman, you've got so many enemies here. Anyway, here comes our next question, which is right here on your screen. I don't know why it's suddenly becoming minimized. The ozone layer restricts dash. Children, everyone knows the answer to this. What does the ozone layer protect us from? Visible light, infrared radiation, X-rays and gamma rays, ultraviolet radiation. What is it? Yes, quickly give me the answer on Menti and not in the chat box here. I want the answer in Menti. So children who have not joined, please join and use the code given here. And your time is up. The answer is absolutely right. 218 of you have told me the answer is ultraviolet radiation. Okay, those of you who've said it's A, B and C, time to strengthen your basics regarding the ozone layer and about the atmosphere. Children, go to www.menti.com. Use the code 4059446. Okay, I can see 277 of you have answered this question, which is very, very good. Okay, great. You will not be able to play Atmik. Okay, why so? All right, and here we have Krithart, class 6 student. All right, Krithart is at position 1. Then we have Yash and Deepanshu, class 9. Remember, ma'am. Okay. Nandini, and then we have Ishika, Naman, is it the same Naman here? Naman, GK Master, Ambika, ma'am. Okay, Ludo, Yash, another Yash we have, Gautam Sai from Mannandala, Trivandrum. Yes, Gautam, high five to you because we live in the same city right now. Devansh, ma'am, you're Sabse Bada fan. Oh, thank you so much. I am on cloud nine listening to all this kindness and hearing all this, all these sweet flattery words. Yes, it's you, Naman. All right, great job. Let us move on to your next question, which is about to appear on your screen right now. Question number three. Yes, eugenics or eugenics is the study of dash. Altering human beings by changing their genetic components, people of European origin, different races of mankind, genetics of plants. What do you think? Eugenics. Yes. Eugenics. What do you think the answer is? Okay. And your time is up. The answer is, as a majority of you have told me, it is option A. Altering human beings by changing their genetic components. I would love to talk more about this. But then since this is supposed to be a KBC special quiz, let us reserve that for one of our bio sessions. Okay. So let us see who has come to the top of the leaderboard. And any major changes? Yes, any new names, any existing people's changes? All right, Yash is back to position one. Good job, Yash. And then we have Deepanshu, Kritarth, Nandini, and just after Nandini, Naman. And then we have Yash, Gautam, Nijam, and then we have RJ and Raj. Okay, welcome to the leaderboard, RJ and Raj. Okay, 82, 83. Who else? Nobody else has told me. I saw another message. Chaitanya, I don't know. Yeah, your message got deleted. Anyway, let's move on. 283 of you have given me the answer to this. Children, whoever has joined now, please don't leave. Please go to www.menti.com and use the code 4059446. Okay? And join us in Menti. Always more the merrier. Okay? So let us have fun together. And here comes your question number four on your screen right now. Let's see, 20 seconds, do remember. Ecology, how many of you know this? Yes, Anjali, tell me what ecology is. Yes, definitely you can play Sakshi, be it class 6, 7, whatever. Ecology deals with birds, cell formation, relation between organisms and their environment, or about tissues. What do you think? Yes, I'm going breathless because of the excitement that's around. Don't tell me I don't know, ma'am. Please give it a guess at least. There's nothing to lose. No negative points. Very, very well done. 242 of you have told me it is the science that deals with relation between organisms and their environment. Okay, it has nothing to do with cells, tissues, nor with birds. Ecology is related to organisms and their relation with the environment, biotic factors, abiotic factors, and the environment that they live in, the interaction between different organisms in nature. Right? Okay. Yes, Shanmugapriya. Hello, Shanmugapriya. Shanmugapriya is such a nice name. It's the name of a Carnatic rag. Okay, Deepanshu is the fastest this time. Well done, Deepanshu. Yash has come down to position 3. Position 2 is maintained by Kritarth. Nandini and Naman, very, very close competition. Yash, Gautam, Nijam, RJ and Raj. I think the rest of it is remaining the same, pretty much the same. Not too much of difference. But look at the point difference, children. Deepanshu and Kritarth, just 1 point difference. Wow. And Yash also, like you are just behind by 3 points. Okay, not a problem at all. Whatever the position is, all that matters is that we learn something new and we have fun together playing this. Okay, so let us move on to the next question. Get ready, children who have not joined. The code is right here on your screen. We are moving on to question number 5 and it is right here. Filaria or filariasis is spread by dash. Yes, bacteria, mosquito, protozoa or virus. It is spread by dash. Filariasis or filaria as it's also commonly known. What do you think? Your last 5 seconds will begin now. And 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Harshil. Hello, Harshil. Hi, back from Trivandrum. Okay, mosquito, as most of you say, is the answer. So, children, if the question was filariasis is caused by, what do you think the answer would have been? If it's about the cause that the question was, the answer would have been Wuchereria, which is a kind of roundworm. Nematodes are responsible for causing the disease filariasis, and it is spread by vectors or carriers, which in this case are certain types of mosquitoes. So good job, whoever has answered it correctly. Here we go. And look at the leaderboard. Wow, 290 of you have given me the answer for this question. Good job. I'm so glad to see that. This is an English channel, Sanjay Kumar. Okay. Yeah. So Kritarth is at position one this time, 2 points behind, and Deepanshu is at position two. Yash is at position three, and that also like is very, very close. Then we have Nandini, Naman, Yash, Gautam, Harshit. Thank you, Harshit. And then we have Nijam and Madhusudan. Okay, welcome Madhusudan and Harshit to the leaderboard. Okay, shall we move on? Yes, already? Top four are all hacking. All right. Okay, let's see. www.menti.com. Use the code 4059446. Children, do remember, it always matters that you play in a straightforward manner and have fun and learn new things. That's all. Okay. So let's move on to question number six, which is on your screen right now. Where is it? Yes. DRDL stands for Dash. How many of you know this? Defense Research and Development Laboratory. The spelling is wrong for laboratory. Department of Research and Development Laboratory, Differential Research and Documentation Laboratory. None of these. Which of them is correct? DRDL. Yes, you are seventh. All right, your time is up. The answer is, of course, Defense Research and Development Laboratory, DRDL. This is the answer, as most of you have told me. And any major changes to the leaderboard? Let us ask. Computer G, as Mr. Amitabh Bachchan says. Right? Okay. And Kritarth is still at position one. Okay. And then we have Deepanshu, like just 4 points behind, and then we have Yash, Nandini and Naman. Okay, and then I think the same set of people, it's pretty much the same. Yash, Gautam Sai, Harshit, Nijam, Hanshita, welcome to the leaderboard, Hanshita. Abhishek sir is best. Okay, I will convey this to Abhishek sir. All right, and let us move on to the next question. Children who have not joined yet, www.menti.com, use the code 4059446. Okay, let's have fun with question number seven. And what is this about? Have a look at your screen. Who was the first Indian chief of army staff of the Indian Army? General K.M. Karyappa, Vice Admiral R.D. Kattari, General Maharaja Rajendra Singh Ji, or none of these? The first Indian Chief of Army Staff of the Indian Army. Yes, how many children from army families here? You guys should certainly know this, and your time is up. Yes, the answer is, of course, option A, General K.M. Karyappa. Yes, as majority of you have told me. And let's look at the leaderboard now. Any changes? 272 of you have given me the answer to this. Okay, we still have three more questions to go, children, so stay right here. Continue and join those of you who are just joining. Join menti.com using the code given here. Kritarth, Deepanshu, same, Yash, Nandini, Naman. I think this is the very first time that the first five people are not at all changing even the order, like for the last few questions. Okay, your grandfather is a retired colonel. Nice to know that, Naman. Okay, and then we have Gautam, Yash, Harshit, Naisa and Ishika. Okay, welcome to the leaderboard, Naisa and Ishika. Okay, thank you, Ananya. Okay, ready guys, let's move on to the next one. You're in the 49th position, okay? Your position doesn't matter. As long as you keep learning things, that's all that matters most, okay? Straightforward people will be rewarded, okay? Coral reefs in India can be found in which of these? The coast of Orissa, Waltair, Rameshwaram, Trivandrum. Okay, what do you think? Orissa, Waltair, Rameshwaram, Trivandrum. Coral reefs in India. Beautiful sight to watch coral reefs. And your time is up. Yes. The answer is Rameshwaram, not what most of you have told me, what 81% of you, second highest, have told me. It is Rameshwaram. And you are absolutely right. Trivandrum doesn't have any coral reefs. Although all of these parts are like located in the coastal regions of India. Like Orissa, what is Voltaire, children? How many of you know what's Voltaire? Visakhapatnam. Okay. Vizag, as it's commonly called, but Vishakhapatnam is how I like saying it. Okay, so Rameshwaram is the answer to this, and there we go on to this question's leaderboard. Any major changes? Computer G will tell us. Okay, children, in the meantime, do remember to keep playing the quiz, okay? In case you've not, download Vedantu's app from Google Play Store and start playing the quiz. Okay, Kritarth, Deepanshu, Yash, Nandini, Naman, and we have Gautam, Yash, Ishika, Utkarsh, and Khushi. Welcome, Utkarsh and Khushi. Nice. Utkarsh, high five, Utkarsh. Yes. So thank you so much, children, for playing so actively. There are still 261 of you who answered this. Your name, Parmesh Gupta. Yes, Parmesh. Okay, children, here comes question number 9. Okay, go to menti.com, use the code 4059446. Just two more questions. Children, doesn't matter, doesn't matter. Let's put aside all sorts of negativity. Let's just focus on our own work. Be true to yourself. Okay, that's all that matters. Okay. So here comes question number 9. And what is that regarding? Okay. Golden Temple, Amritsar, is India's largest Gurdwara, oldest Gurdwara. Both A and B are correct, or none of these. What do you think? Golden Temple. It's one of my dream destinations, one of those places in India which I have never got to visit until now. I would love to visit the Golden Temple at some point of time. Okay, and your time is up. Well, option A is the correct answer. Children, you know what I always say in all my sessions on YouTube and in my regular sessions also, I say, whether or not it makes sense, if at all there is an option that says both A and B or both B and C, all of the above or none of the above, especially if it's all of the above or both A and B or something like that, that has to be the answer for many of you. But unfortunately, that doesn't always work. The answer to this question is largest Gurdwara, Golden Temple, Amritsar is not the oldest one, but it is definitely the largest Gurdwara in India. And yes, a very, very famous, popular tourist destination also. I really hope, despite being asked already, so many children have got it wrong. Doesn't matter. Okay, so Kritarth is still at the top. Okay, 10 points difference now between position 1, 2, and 3, which is Kritarth, Deepanshu, Yash, and then we have Nandini, Naman, Gautam, Ishika, Utkarsh. Yes, Utkarsh, high five once again. Yash and Kushi. Okay, I don't see any new names here. It's just the last three names are shuffling here and there. That's all. But the first five are pretty much constant. First six are pretty much constant. Okay, let's move on. Children, you've been to Golden Temple and it's a beautiful place, right, Naman? I've also heard this, but unfortunately, I've never visited. Okay, children, going on to the last question for today. Aditya, hi, ma'am, Malayali here. Okay, nice to know that. Yes, Sachidanand, high five. Children, get ready. Last question, question number 10 for the day. Those of you who have not participated until now, please do join. menti.com, use the code 4059446. And your last question for today's KBC special quiz is here. Fathometer is used to measure dash, earthquakes, rainfall, ocean depth, sound intensity. Use your common sense. Fathometer, what do you think it's used to measure? Oh, Purvika, yes, you are very late. This is our very last question for the day, my dear. Unfortunately, not a problem. You can still join our upcoming quizzes. Okay, so your time is up. The answer is, of course, it is ocean depth. The depth of the sea or depth of the ocean is what we use fathometer for. So, definitely. Very good choice of answer, children. 246 of you have given me the answer to that. And let's look at the leaderboard, which is going to be the final leaderboard for the day. And I think it's still dominated by Kritarth. So, All right, Kritarth is at the top today with 9,967 points. So, Kritarth, very, very well done. Agnes, your full name, Melita Agnes de Souza. Okay, not a problem, Vijay Tarishan. Please keep trying because we will still keep coming up with more and more such special mentee quizzes, regardless of whether it's going to be for KPC preparation or whether it's for our subjects, for our individual subjects. At the end of each chapter, we normally give mentee quizzes. So it doesn't matter. Whenever possible, please do join children because that is what keeps us going and that is what keeps us bonded together also. So children, thank you so much and I really hope you have enjoyed this quiz. Please do hit the like button right now because I know there were close to 300 of you across the entire quiz. So please do hit the like button right now. Share it with all your friends who would find this interesting because ultimately, even if they can't play live when you share it, all that matters is that you learn something new. That's what matters most at the end of the day. And do click on the subscribe button right now in case you haven't done it yet. Stay subscribed to Vedantu 9th and 10th English because as you know, we are just about 4 months, 4 to 5 months away from your final exams and we are in full swing trying to complete your syllabus right here on this channel. And once your syllabus is done, based on your feedback and suggestions, we would love to come up with new and more creative revision sessions also. And don't forget to download Vedantu's app from Google Play Store if you haven't done that yet because keep playing VQuiz 11 a.m. and 7 p.m. every day. Today is already the 16th, right? Till the 18th of October, you have your golden opportunity open right in front of you. Keep playing the quiz and get your chance boosted to get shortlisted for KBC's Student Special Week Hot Seat. Okay, children. Amitabh Bachchan movie dialogue. No, I will be very bad to say that. Okay. As such, I don't want any comments made on that. Abhishek sir can do it for you. Yeah. All right, children. So thank you very much. I will meet you once again until we meet again in yet another super interesting session. Stay happy, stay safe, take care of your health. It matters really, really, really a lot. Okay. You are valuable to us and let's work together and make your learning journey a lot smoother and simpler and more fun than it ever has been. Okay. So high five to all of my dear children. This is Ambika signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.